You talk about letdowns. Somebody who hasn't been letting down Buffalo all year is Jeff Skinner. His new digs.
You know what? Jeff Skinner is a really interesting player, and I'm really fascinated to see what happens to him down the stretch here. He couldn't play any better. If you were the general manager of the Buffalo Sabres and you said, we're going to acquire Jeff Skinner, and I like what he's done in the past. I think he can give us 30 goals or something like that. He finds the right holes at the right time. He's got these magnificent hands in tight spaces like you just saw right there. You still wouldn't have imagined 18 at this point.
Yeah. No, he's found a great chemistry with Jack Eichel to this point, which has been terrific for him. And
let me correct myself. 19.
There you go.
Yeah, so these guys are scoring so rapidly.
I know.
Tim and Line A. 19 to this point. I want to hear from all the Buffalo fans.
Yeah, well, you will hear from them, yes. As I well know. I will say about Jeff Skinner, the thing that's been impressive to me lots is that he has been going into, like people say, Jeff Skinner, man, he's a perimeter player. Watch the games. He gets right into the battle, right into the dirtier area. That's how he's scoring goals. So I give him a lot of credit. He's fitting really nicely in Buffalo. We will see. I think when we talk about a long-term deal for Jeff Skinner, we'll wait till after the new year because he was traded.
It's good timing for a year like this.
Perfect timing, right? But they can't do an 8-year deal until after the first of the year because he was acquired in a trade. So they'll talk about it. I think it'll be interesting to see what kind of number they can come up with there.
But I wouldn't sign him to an 8-year deal.
If I'm Jeff Skinner, though, I'm liking staying in Buffalo. I'm liking being with Jack Eichel. It's near where he lives. He grew up in Ontario. Yeah. A lot of positives there. So we'll see how it plays out. But right now, playing great.
By the way, if you do want to be heard or want them to hear from you, I'm talking about Lots and EJ, you can send us your tweets. I'll ask them any questions that you have over the next hour.
Unless you're from Buffalo.
No.
All comers here. Yes. All right, so Skinner on one side, Mike Hoffman on the other, in terms of newcomers who are fitting right in.
Yeah, he's a little different because he scores from distance, you know, and like you see here is a wraparound, so as soon as I say that, we show one there. But a lot of times he's going to be able to score from distance. And that's what's made him a special player in this league. He's got the ability to shoot the puck. There it is right there. He's been really good on the power play. They've set him up in that spot. And so it's been a good fit for the Florida Panthers to date. The key for Hoffman moving forward is, you know, can the Florida Panthers, can they put enough guys around him and can they, you know, get that goaltending fix with Luongo out? But he's been a nice fit for the Florida Panthers so far.
Mike Hoffman's been a great fit. And the two best deals really from the summer were guys that teams bought low on.
Let's call it what it is.
These were
guys.
Hoffman
was a little bit of a damaged asset,
exactly,
right? Because of the things that had
gone on. It doesn't matter what the reasons are. Yeah. That's just the fact of the matter. Yeah. And Mike Hoffman is enjoying his time tremendously in Florida. He loves it down there. He's played very well for them. And both the Panthers and the Buffalo Sabres really benefited from guys that they had just a little bit of chink in their armor somewhere. So it doesn't matter, again, what it was. Jeff Skinner had some injuries in the past. Yeah. I think that hurt him a little bit with the concussions. Not the biggest player. On the other hand, Hoffman just coming out of a very tumultuous situation in Ottawa. Great moves by both clubs. Yeah.